let's take a close look at the art element, colour. Scientifically, colour is produced when light strikes an object and is reflected back to the eye. When we see an arrangement of colours in the sky, caused by light shining through droplets of rain, we call it a rainbow. This arrangement of colours is known as a spectrum. The spectrum in order is red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. In art theory, colours are called hues. In 1706, Sir Isaac Newton arranged the colours of a spectrum in a circle, creating the first colour wheel. The colour wheel developed over time and is still used today by artists worldwide. The colour wheel in general is very basic, however, and does not include all of the lighter or darker variations of the colours that we see. In theory, the primary colours are three colours that every other colour can be mixed from if using paint. The primary colours are red, yellow, and blue. They are called primary colours because they cannot be created by mixing other colours together. When two primary colours are mixed together, a secondary colour is created. Red mixed with yellow creates orange, blue mixed with red creates purple, yellow mixed with blue creates green. There are many different blues, reds, and yellows available in any art shop, so the results can change depending on what primary hues you choose in the first place. The best thing to do is experiment to see what combinations you prefer. On the colour wheel, the colours that are placed opposite each other are complementary colours. They are blue and orange, purple and yellow, and red and green. When they are placed beside each other, they contrast and compete with each other visually. Colour has appeared in art for thousands of years, and how it is created has changed significantly over time. Pigment is the substance that makes up the colour in a paint. From the first cave paintings right up to modern day, pigments have been made from various ingredients such as organic material, minerals, metals, and synthetic substances. Colour in the history of art has changed dramatically over time, from the subdued colours of the Renaissance, to the use of black to create tone in the Baroque era, to bright, colourful art by the Impressionists who painted outdoors in natural light. The art movements, post-impressionism, expressionism, cubism, fauvism, and modernism all utilized color in different ways. Many contemporary painters use vibrant colors in their works and play with interesting color combinations. Art rooms should have lots of color displayed to fuel ideas. One way to paint with color is to use two complementary colors with either white or black. The darkest color can be used for shadow, the lightest for the highlight, and the middle colour as the mid-tone. Colour can be used to depict expression, using warm colours to create a happy, cosy indoor scene, or using cooler colours to depict a gloomy winter's day. Whatever way you want to pursue the use of colour in your artwork, two things are absolutely essential. One, experimentation. This leads to amazing discoveries and knowledge of your tools. 2. Having fun. Enjoying art making will lead to passion and pride in your work.